Since this episode is all about being Filipino, I'm going to take it back down to my roots for my bucket list and go for an old art form called pottery. Ever since Ghost, I've been wanting to do this, so I'm going to be channeling my inner Demi while I'm here at Cornerstone Pottery Farm. Cornerstone Pottery Farm is a vast property located in Silang, Cavite. Co-owner EJ Espiritu, a certified ceramic engineer, ensures that their pottery is produced in an ecologically safe manner for both environment and people. I'm here right now with EJ Espiritu, who is the owner of Cornerstone Pottery Farm. Thank you so much for having us here today.
It's our pleasure.
Can you tell me more about Cornerstone Pottery Farm?
We started the company in 1996 as a subcontractor for an exporter. And then by the year 2000, we launched a new product line, the stoneware pottery.
So as a Filipino who has penetrated the international market, how does it make you feel?
Feels great. Mm-hmm. It's a great opportunity for us to showcase our art, our product, and at the same time, we're able to help the local people have employment.
EJ introduces me to his line of products. The chimes, teacups, pots, yogurt bowls, and sauce dishes are all equally impressive. And it seems I'm not the only one dazzled by all these. Cornerstone Pottery Farm has its own share of local and foreign clients.
This is really beautiful.
The handmade plates and bowls.
Wow.
So the client is actually very supportive. And they come here twice a year and help us conceptualize new designs.
Aside from making these amazing products, Cornerstone Pottery Farm also offers workshops for those who are interested to learn the craft. And they even have their own bed and breakfast to sweeten the deal. And now it's time for Pottery 101. Apparently, it's all a matter of patting the clay, centering, tilting, adding the right amount of water, and kicking the wheel to make it spin. Wow, I hope I get to remember all this later.
So awesome. Don't expect that from me.
This is our bowl, and you'll try to make something like this.
I will try to make something. Good. Okay. And my clay is going to be itty bitty bitty. Time to get my hands dirty. Sitting on the wheel is exactly like riding a pony. Giddy up.
So is that not fast enough?
It's only first gear. We need third gear.
Oh, what's third gear? It's like a different way of driving a car.
Pottery was a workout. Okay. Seems I'm having a hard time with the centering. It makes me feel a lot better knowing that it usually takes more than one session to master the art of centering.
Okay, so I have officially failed at centering. So EJ's gonna do it for me first.
That's right.
And then we will go into the rest of it. Okay. Let us not fall off.
Yeah, it kind of looks like a bowl now, thank goodness, but it's all really complicated. Pottery is a craft that takes a whole lot of patience. And with enough practice, I'm sure this little bowl that I made will be having some companions pretty soon. So it's really great to make this part of my bucket list because I have a newfound appreciation as a Filipino to nurture our crafts and to actually go back and learn it. So for me, it is great to see that this is here locally and that you and your friends can do this for fun. And who knows, maybe next time you'll become an artist yourself.